Welcome to our video on how to be successful with Zendesk Messaging, where we'll discuss how to set up your messaging workflows in order to get the most out of the product. There are five critical steps to take when successfully implementing and utilizing Zendesk Messaging. We'll go into each of these in a bit more detail, but the steps are: learn or understand exactly what the platform is and what your team could do with it, plan and map how the tool can be implemented across your team, configure, test, and upgrade. Make sure that the channel is built to your standards to match your workflow goals. Operationalize or learn more about how the tool can be improved in practice. And finally, transform your customer experience. First and foremost, you'll want to learn about the product, what all is possible with messaging, and what will you gain when implementing the tool. Messaging gives teams everything they need to deliver rich, conversational experiences that you can easily automate across web, mobile, and social apps. With messaging, you can connect with your customers wherever they are on the web, mobile, or their favorite social channel, and keep that conversation going without ever losing the context history. Support one ticket across multiple channels, all from the same place. Deliver faster and more efficient service at scale using out-of-the-box tools for building your own custom bot. And finally, creating more engaging experiences across the customer lifecycle, thanks to our open and flexible platform. After learning all about messaging and the incredible things it can do for you and your team, the next step to a successful implementation is to plan your rollout of the tool. We want to ensure you're prepared and know what to expect when enabling messaging, because messaging undoes many of the established operational procedures that businesses have used to support their customers over the last few decades. But don't worry, again, that's why you're here, to learn how to prepare yourself and your team for an improved messaging experience. To ensure a seamless transition, we've put together this guide to help you through your planning phase. Think of it as a blueprint you can follow or adapt to your specific needs to help you plan your move. When planning your messaging workflows, it's very important to gather your requirements. What needs do you have that need to be met with messaging? Is it something that's out of the box, or will you need customization? Map out your ideal conversational experience. How do you want your customers to feel when they interact with your team? What would you like the agent experience to be like? Design your bot flows. Is adding a bot something that you're considering? What would you like that experience to be like, and how can you put it into practice? Create your communications plan. How are you going to tell your team? What change management model will you be following? Will you be sending out messaging to your customers? Organize regular check-ins. How will you be keeping track of new issues? What is the process to troubleshoot and fix any potential problems? And finally, conduct impact assessments. Who will be impacted by the deployment of messaging? What is the impact, risk, and mitigation plan when introducing this new channel? By asking yourself these questions, you're ensuring that you're planning for all aspects of implementation from start to finish. So you've learned and you've planned, and now it's time to get messaging up and running. We want to ensure you know what it takes to go from the planning to the execution phase, starting from enabling messaging on your account, all the way to deploying the experience on your website or help center. First things first, you'll need to enable and customize messaging, which can be done in a few quick and simple steps. Next, if you do so, you'll configure your custom bot. We recommend turning on bot-enabled messaging in the admin center to help with information gathering and streamline ticket routing. Third, you'll want to configure your instance to accommodate this new channel. This means setting up business rules, ticket views, reporting, and more. After configuration, you'll want to preview and test your workflows. Whether it's in your enterprise sandbox account or a test group, you want to avoid surprises before you go live. And don't forget about your team. You'll want to train them. Show your agents how to deliver support on this new channel and how to use the tool in an effective way. Check in with them regularly. And don't forget the importance of change management. This is not only a change that your customers will experience, but a new and exciting change for your agents as well. Their feedback matters too. And finally, the big moment, deploying your new messaging experience. Be sure to triple check everything before enabling on your site or your help center. Test, test, test again for good measure. Now that messaging is up and running, it's time to operationalize. We know you've knocked it out of the park, but there are a few things you'll want to get ahead of. Staffing and workforce management. Unfortunately, not all conversations happen live, so the way you plan for and staff to deliver the customer experience will undoubtedly change. It's important to ensure your team is properly staffed and scheduled to support messaging as a channel. Zendesk does offer our own workforce management solution, TimeShift, and if you're interested in learning more, we recommend getting in touch with your account executive. KPIs and reporting. It's important to have metrics behind your messaging channel that support its effectiveness and progress. We recommend tracking metrics such as total messaging tickets solved, number of missed messaging tickets, and more. Workflows. With messaging, your widget is always on, even when your agents are not. The way you manage ongoing conversations requires careful thought and planning. Planning should be grounded in the way you handle various offline scenarios, triage and escalate tickets, and manage the views to accommodate for these new service delivery components. And finally, bot building. Bots and automations are one of the foundations that messaging is built on. You need to think about what you want your bot to be able to do, figure out what it should and shouldn't handle, and how it should involve other parties in scenarios where the human touch is needed. It's important to note that improvements can always be made, so as you continue your use of messaging, continue to make improvements as needed. We have now made it to the fifth and final step of your successful messaging implementation, transforming your business with messaging. Messaging has forever changed the way we connect with friends and family, and now customers expect to be able to have the same type of conversation with the businesses that they support. 9 out of 10 customers want to message businesses, and nearly half of businesses offering messaging because it provides customers with faster time to resolution. Additionally, 42% say that they offer messaging for personalized interactions so that they can create better relationships between their brand and their customers, resulting in an increase in their customer loyalty. Zendesk messaging is out of the box, easy to use, and customizable where you need it to be, and scales as you grow, allowing you to provide seamless customer support on any channel. With this 5-step process, you and your team will be able to successfully use messaging for an exceptional customer experience. Thank you for watching this video, and we'll see you next time.